Hello everyone, welcome to Linux Hub tutorial. Today I am going to show you how to install and configure Drupal in Ubuntu. Drupal is an open source content management system which allows you to create your own website. By using Drupal, you can able to create your websites easily for free of cost, and you can able to create your website very fast. To install Drupal, you need to set up LAMP server on your local machine. LAMP means Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP. Now I am going to set up that LAMP server. For that, login as root, sudo space hyphen s and enter. Now type your password and enter. Now you need to install packages for setting LAMP server. Before that, update your repositories by running the command apt-get space update and enter. Now my repositories is updated. To set up the LAMP server, run the following command. This is the command apt-get install, and these are the required packages to set up the LAMP server. Now hit enter. It will ask you for the confirmation. Now press Y and hit enter. Now the packages is downloading. Wait for some time. With the installation of MySQL server, it will ask you for the root password. Now enter the root password for MySQL server. Retype the password. Now hit enter. Now it's unpacking all the packages. Wait until it completes. Now all the packages is installed for LAMP server, and my LAMP server is set now. Next, we are going to create the database for Drupal by using MySQL database. Now we enter into your MySQL database by typing the command mysql space hyphen u space root space hyphen p, and now enter. Now enter the password. This password you gave while the installation of MySQL. Type your password and hit enter. Now we have entered into the MySQL database. Here we need to do some steps for creating database and database user and setting permissions for the database user. Now run the following command to create the database user. This is the command you need to type. This command will create the user called Drupal in localhost. This user will identified by this password 123. Now hit enter. Now the database user is created. Now run the following command to create the database. Now type this command. This command will create the new database called Drupal. Now hit enter. Next I am going to grant all permissions for the Drupal user for all the tables inside the Drupal database. For that, run the following command. This command will grant all permissions for Drupal user for all tables inside the Drupal database. Now hit enter. And now run this command to flush the privileges. Now hit enter. Now exit from MySQL. Type exit and hit enter. Next I am going to edit the php.ini file. For that, run the command vim space slash etc slash php5 slash apache2 slash php.ini and hit enter. In this file, look for the following parameters, which is expose underscore php and allow underscore url underscore fopen. And finally, extension equal to msql.so. To find these parameters in this file, you can simply type slash and enter the parameter you want to search for. I type expose underscore php and enter. Here this parameter is equal to of, you need to set the parameter equal to of. Now look for the second parameter, type slash, type allow underscore url and hit enter. Here this is the parameter. Here change to off. Now look for the third parameter, press escape. Now type slash, now type msql and enter. Here this is the parameter. Come down, press I for insert mode. Come here, remove the semicolon. Now save the file. Now open the apache2.conf file, which is located in this directory, vim space slash etc slash apache2 slash apache2.conf and hit enter. Here come down. Here we need to change this allow override none to allow override all. Press I for insert mode. Now change it to all. After changing, save the file. Now restart the Apache service by running the command service space apache2 space restart and enter. Now run the following command to enable the rewrite functionality for Apache server. Now type a2 enmode space rewrite and hit enter. Here it's asking to restart the service, so restart the Apache service once again. Now hit enter. Next I am going to download the Drupal package in Drupal's official website. For that you can go to the Drupal's official website to download the package, or copy the link address and use the duplicate command to download the package. Now type the command wget space and paste your link address here. This is the link address to download the Drupal package from the internet. Now hit enter. Now the package is downloading. Now the download is completed. Type ls and hit enter. Here you can see this is the package we have downloaded from internet. This is in tar format. We need to extract this package by using tar command. So type tar space hyphen jetxf space package name and hit enter. Now the package is extracting. After extracting, type the command ls and enter. Here you can see a new directory will be created in the name of Drupal. Now we need to copy all the content inside this directory to our document root of our Apache web server. Before that, create a directory called Drupal inside the document root. For that, type the command mkdir space slash var slash www slash html slash Drupal and hit enter. Now copy all the content inside this directory to this directory, which is located under the document root directory. For that, run the following command. This is the command you need to type. This command will copy all the content inside this directory to this directory, and we need to copy this hidden file also from this directory. This file called .htaccess is a hidden file which is located inside this directory. We need to copy this file also to our document root directory. Now hit enter. Now create a directory under this Drupal directory. For that, run the following command. Now type this command to create a directory under this path. Now hit enter. Now change this directory permission to www-data for the users and groups. Now run the command chown space www-data colon www-data space and this directory path. Now hit enter. Now run the following command. This is the command. By using this command, we are simply copying this file and rename it as settings.php, which is located under this directory path. Now hit enter. Now we need to change the permission for this file. For that, run the following command. This is the command. This command will change the user and group ownership to www-data for this settings.php file, which is located under this directory path. Now hit enter. Now once again restart the Apache service by running the command service space apache 2 space restart and hit enter. Now open your browser. Now use this URL to open the Drupal installation page. This is my IP address. This is the Drupal directory we have created under the document root. Now enter. Now the Drupal installation is started. Now choose your language and click save and continue. Here choose this option standard, or if you want to choose minimal you can choose. I am choosing standard and click save and continue. Here enter your database name we have created as Drupal, and the database user is also called Drupal, and the password 123. Now click save and continue. Choose never remember. Now the Drupal is installing. Wait for some time. After the installation completes, it will open this page. Here we need to configure our site. Here type your site name. Here type the email address for your site. Now type the username for your site and give the password for the user account. Here choose your country and time zone. Now click save and continue. Now we have successfully installed Drupal. This is our home page for Drupal site. Here you can create your own site. Now click here to add the content to the site. Click basic page. Here give the title for your site. And here type the source code for your site. Now click here. Now type the source code. Now enter your source code here. And then click save and publish. By the same way, you can add your own content here to create your own website inside this Drupal site. Now click here to log out. So this is how we can create our own office by using Drupal. Hope this video is helpful for you. Thank you for watching.